So welcome again to this course on ROS perception. In this unit, we are going to learn how to do phase detection. And not only that, but in the next units, we'll learn how to recognize faces and how to track people. So we will work in simulations with simulated people, more or less models, that have different physiognomy and so on. They are made with Maker Human, a software to generate people. And basically what we have is, in this simulation, we will have this. Let's do it a bit bigger. So we have the fetch that you know already from previous units of object recognition. And here we have the person standing with it, which is one of the models. It's the model given in Gazebo by default. So there you go. So in this unit, you're going to learn how to detect faces. What's the difference between detecting faces and recognizing faces? Well, the difference basically is that here I see, okay, detect faces is simply I detect a face. But if I have more than one person, you can't know who that person is. To do that, you need face recognition, which we will do in the next unit. Okay? Great. So let's start. So you're going to learn how to use the face detector package. This package has been in ROS for a while already, and here you have the documentation. I highly recommend you that you take a look at it. As you can see, you can use it for real persons, of course. All the things that you're learning in this course, you can apply them, of course, in real life. And it's here, there's not a lot of, so you have some details, extra details, but maybe you should see the source code also, because sometimes there are not a lot of very specific details on how to do it here. Okay, so you could see the Git and have a look at it if you need more information, or the code API, basically. Okay, this is highly recommendable that you have a look, especially if you want to use it in depth. Okay, so what do you have to do? First thing first, you have to create a package that depends on ROSPY because we're using Python, and face detector package because we're using the package. Then we are going to create the face detection launch. That's it. And we are going to talk about piece by piece. Let's have a look here because we have syntax highlights. So I go, we have face detector launch. Let's close this, and face detection TC. So here you have more or less what you have to launch. So here you are launching the face detector. Let's have a look at this one, because this we'll see it afterwards. So this one is the most basic thing you need to launch the face detection, which is, first, you have to give the names of the different sensors that you will use. Essentially, the RGB and the depth sensors. You can see here that it's using a different system as you used in the object recognition unit. You don't give the whole topic, but you give the namespaces. It's shorter, but maybe it's a bit more confusing, so be careful with that. So you have the camera namespace, and below it then you have the image topic, or maybe the depth namespace, and so on. Let's have a look. ROS topic camera. So ROS topic list, and then we do a grep of head camera, sorry. Head camera. As you can see, you have head camera for all of them, but then you have the RGB, and then you have also the depth. And what it does is, because the RGB is always the same, so it's head camera RGB and all like that, then you give it only the name, which can change depending on the sensors that you're using. And then the depth, it's the same thing. The depth sensor, you see, we're giving depth registered. So because we have two, depth downsample and depth registered. And then the name of the topic. So in this case is image raw in both RGB and depth. And then the fixed frame that you're using. And then what we do is give it, so remap those and give that parameters basically. And then you give it some other parameters, which we won't talk about because it's a bit higher level. And essentially, if you use the default values, it works fine. If you want to go deeper in how this works, you'll have to see the API and see each value and each option that you, that the system, the package gives you. Okay, fantastic. So that's it. Basically, the exercise that you have to do is create the package and launch this launch that starts the face detection. So let's do it. I'm going to ROS launch my face, face detector, and then simple. In my case, I put simple here. Running. Okay. And nothing happens. Why nothing happens? Because this is a very well done package, and it won't publish anything, and unless you subscribe to the topics. If you ask information, then it will start publishing. Otherwise, it won't do anything, which is good, because that way you don't overload your system. So next step. Well, next step is creating the client that asks for the information, and that way the server will start publishing the data that we need. So here's the face detector client launch that you'll need to do, and basically it's a launch of a node, Python, like that, nothing special. And the Python, it's again very simple subscriber, just comment on what we have to subscribe to. We have to subscribe to the face detector people tracker measurement array. It's type position measurement array, and we have this callback, which, as you can see, we are not doing anything really. We're just saving the data. That's it. This is a client just to start the server publishing stuff. Data. So these people tracker measurements array, what information does this give us? Does it give us position, orientation, names? So as you can see here, you have the header, like always, and then you have an array of position measurement. So if you get 5 persons, then it will generate 5 different elements in this array. So that's good. We can track multiple faces. That's fantastic. You even have an object ID, so you can track different faces in space. And it gives you a position, so X, Y, and Z. Not orientation, because you don't need it, but a position, so X, Y, and Z. It's more than enough. Then other like statistical values and so on is not relevant right now. So Exercise 2 is create this client script and launch it and see what it happens. Okay, so I'm going to close this. I'm going to launch now the face detector, which in my case, as you can see here, is the one I showed you before, plus I'm launching the client. That's it. So let's launch the client. Well, we are launching here the server and the client. There we go. So you see, it's detecting faces. Number of face match 1, ID 1, blah, blah, blah. Okay, so now let's see the data. How? With RVIS. So RVIS. In our system, you can launch RVIS directly like this. You don't have to ROS run. So that's an advantage for Robot Ignite. And there we go. So as you can see, we have point cloud, like in the object, recognition is the same thing. But we don't need this, actually. But we are going to leave it, okay? Then we're going to add, and we are going to add, let me see, here, people position measurement array. We are adding this. And we have to select the topic. There's only one, so nothing strange here. And there we go. So it's detecting the face, and more or less it's detecting the face where the face, the real face, is. So great. Go. Okay. Now let's get rid of the point cloud. Now that we are sure that it's detecting what it should. There we go. So as you can see, this person, it's also publishing TF. But this is not based on that, on this TF. It's based on the detections. So if I move the person around, it should move around with it. So here we have it. Here you have the explanation, more or less, what to do and so on. So the exercise number 3. You have to move the fetch robot around and the person also to see how this tracking works and if it's robust or not. You know how to move the base already. And to move the person, you move it the exact same way as you move the objects. But also you have this launch, which is, it's, let me have a look. There we go. So now we can move it around with a keyboard. It's okay. So you can turn it around. For example, we're going to move it around here, and we're going to move it there. Okay. There we go. So now, yeah, it moved. So the TF is here, and the face recognition, so it's working. Fantastic, fantastic. So your exercise is a bit more complex because you'll need to know, you'll need to track. First, move the robot around with base and moving the person to see if you're tracking it's okay. And then what I would like you to do is create a new fetch moving script that moves the fetch robot trying to follow the person based on the face detections. So when it doesn't detect any face, it doesn't move or has a recovery or searching mechanism, as you wish, but when it detects a person face, it goes to that person. Understood? So that's your exercise. And when you finish, you can go to the project, to the part of face detection, and you have an exercise with Ivor Robot, which is you have to do the same thing that you did here. So detect persons, but in this case you have two persons there. And you have to detect one face, go to that face, and when you arrive there, then search for another face and go there. Remember that you, when you go to the first one and you arrive there, then when you search other faces, you have to filter that face that you've already visited. Okay? So it's quite fun exercise. And that's it. It was a short unit. I hope you learned how to, it was easy to detect faces. And the next unit will be face recognition. So knowing who is who. And that's quite it for the unit. Please leave a thumbs up if you liked it, and subs if you loved it, and that's it. Thanks, and see you in the next unit.